Access granted.
This is the personal audio log of Dr. Frank Serrano, dated September 19th, 2145. I've been brainstorming on Betruger's thoughts about achieving sustained, uninterrupted transfers for the teleportation units. Currently, our systems can only build enough of a charge to have the portals open for approximately 10 to 15 seconds. It's enough time to get a team through, but not enough time to send in some of the heavier equipment. Engineering in the Inpro facility informed me that we can theoretically boost the active portal time to 45 seconds quite easily. But this will require rerouting power from central processing, and we just can't afford the downtime. The power requirements for the system are astronomical. We're sucking power from three vanes in Inpro just to power chamber one. I have no idea how we can sustain transfers for longer than 60 seconds without giving serious thought to reorganizing the teleport power grid. I'll sleep on this. This is Dr. Frank Serrano signing off.
Troy. Decontamination chamber sequence initiated. Decontamination process started. Decontamination complete. Have a nice day. Thank you. Please select teleport destination. Pad 2 selected. Decontamination process started. Decontamination complete. Have a nice day.
My patience with you is wearing. Look around you, Marine. Everyone is dead, and soon you will join them.
Decontamination complete. Have a nice day.
My patience with you is wearing. Look around you, Marine. Everyone is dead, and soon you will join them. Look around you, Marine. Everyone is dead, and soon you will join them.
Thank you.
Access granted.
Thank you.
Warning, chamber malfunction.
Thank you.
Please select teleport destination. Pad 3 selected. Decontamination chamber sequence initiated. Decontamination process started. Primary system failure. System shutdown. Backup systems online.
Stop him!
Maintenance personnel needed in chamber 3. Decontamination process started. Primary system failure. System shutdown. Backup systems online.
Stop him!
Maintenance personnel needed in chamber 3. Selected.
This is the audio log of Dr. Martin Schultz, dated August 7th, 2145. We need to amend the operating procedure. Just to ensure that all target teleport markers are properly set and locked before engaging the systems. We had a tragic accident today in Chamber 1 that led to the death of Susan, one of our female chimps. She stepped onto the platform during the calibration phase. An electrical short gauged the system and literally split her in two. Her torso appeared at the destination marker, while her lower extremities remained in place on the source pin. I'm not sure how we've gone this long without this problem appearing sooner, but it seems like we've been having nothing but difficulties getting these systems to work. I don't know where Betruger finds the energy. He's been busy slaving away in the labs for 16 hours a day trying to debug these latest problems. What's he trying to do? Make the rest of his working sets look bad? Regardless, we have our work cut out for us over the next couple of days, going over all the system's logs to see exactly what went wrong with this round of tests. Dr. Martin Schultz signing off, hoping to report better news next time.
Selected.
Making progress, Marine? Your journey is futile. You will die, and your soul will be mine. You will never find the thing you seek. It is trapped in hell forever.
Run. I am everywhere, and you will never find me.